Welcome back to the Pitch Pod, everyone. I'm Jeff Stebbins, and I'm here with my co-host, Joe Janner. Joe, how are you doing today?
Jeff, I'm doing fine. I'm here enjoying the late September weather that we've been blessed with here, and I'm happy to be, look at me, outside, enjoying the sunshine and the fresh breeze. Loving it. How about you, Jeff?
I'm comfortable. I prefer to stay indoors. You know, I have allergies, so I'm nice and cozy indoors, but hey, I'm happy that it's late September. We're about to hit October, but I'm happy for other reasons, Joe. This is the time of the year we have Champions League kicking off. We're approaching match day two. Are you excited for this?
Absolutely. Looking forward to see how Newcastle, I mean, I'm excited. You got to imagine those 50 plus thousand that are going to be packing St. James. Hosting PSG is going to be something to talk about. And I'm looking forward to this game. I think it's going to be a great sporting contest. So, yeah, I'm really excited about this upcoming match.
Yeah, me too. And, yeah, just I can't even imagine being able to attend that game or to, you know, enjoy outside the stadium, the events there. So the people there on the ground, that's just a whole nother level of excitement. But I'm looking forward to it. And two great teams, Newcastle of the EPL going against PSG. Joe, initial thoughts?
I mean, I think we've talked – anytime we've referenced Newcastle, especially over the last year, we talk about them being a difficult team to beat. You know, they went on the road. They held themselves to a 0-0 draw. I think it's a positive result. I think even in the previous episode, we talked about how significant that would be. But now they get an opportunity at home to host PSG side that – I mean, really, early on, it's got to be something they're looking at. Can we get 3 points? I think similar to conversations before, I think this is, you know, yes, match two. Nothing's going to be decided even after this contest, win, lose, or draw. But going for the win, I think, is something that they will aspire to do.
Yeah. In Newcastle, they've just been thriving under their new manager. They're looking great in the EPL. Obviously, they're coming off a strong season last year with a fourth-place finish in the league. And then you have PSG, who, of course, is led by the great Mbappe. So, Joe, if you're Newcastle, how do you handle Mbappe? He's so fast, so elusive, knows what runs to make, he can score. How do you shut this guy down if you're Newcastle?
We know what they're looking to do. We know that it's Mbappe out in the wing. They're trying to get him isolated in 1v1 situations. Trippier plays on that side. I think that he'll be well prepared for understanding and being able to predict and being able to have a firm grasp on it, understanding exactly what the phase of play and how the transition will look like so that they can be well prepared for it. Then it's isolating him out there. It's keeping him outside so that he's not able to cut in, get inside. I mean, it's a strong back line you have there with Newcastle. I think they're going to be well prepared to know exactly what Mbappe is going to bring. And then it's probably so much that they need to make sure they probably don't overemphasize. There are still other players that can influence and still contribute to what PSG can bring. So I think it's maybe finding just the right balance between understanding what they have as that particular threat, but also not forgetting that there's other quality aside in front of them that also has means and ways to go about scoring. So I think that's partially the idea, understanding the threat, but also not overcompensating and making it too much of a one-person game and being able to provide defensively what they need to do. Then when they win the ball, can they transition? I mean, one of the bigger criticisms thus far, Newcastle not really having that true number 10, a true creative player that can really do a lot to help facilitate some of the front line so they can score more. It's maybe partially a concern, but I think Newcastle will be fine just getting by with 1-0 win. I think they'd be fine, again, isolating the threat from Mbappe and doing what they need to get one, whether it be here, there, or however. Get the one goal, go on with 3 points, and be in a very good spot.
Yeah,
in this contest.
I think that's a great insight. Is how do you? Yes, you know Mbappe is a threat, but how do you manage that threat? And I like how you said that. Keep him on the outside, isolate it. Maybe Newcastle tries to possess the ball more. I don't know if that's what's going to happen. And the other good thing that Newcastle has is they have a solid keep. So even if, you know, Mbappe is elusive enough to get past that back four, well, you still have a chance with a solid keep. So, I don't think it's I give a given win for PSG just because of Mbappe, like you said. So it's going to be a great contest. I'm looking forward to it. Are there any other takeaways, Joe, or are you ready to make your prediction already?
Again, I think it's important to recognize how exciting this should be for everybody in European football, that you have a top side such as PSG featuring a top player, Mbappe now getting a chance to travel to a historical, significant, giant club like Newcastle, be able to showcase what this Champions League contest is all about. And that's what we're here. That's why we're talking about it, right? Within this match, within this group, very important for, I think, showcasing what this contest is about. So I think hopefully a lot of eyes and ears are on this contest and looking forward to seeing how it turns out one way or the other. Yeah, I do have an idea of how this goes, Jeff, but you take it. What do you got?
You know what? This is going to be a good game. I don't think either team's going to just run away with it. But if I have to make my prediction, which I do, because that's what we do here at the Pitch Pod, I'm going to go with a 1-1 draw. I think Mbappe is going to score, but I think getting a win for PSG at Newcastle, I think that's going to be a tough task. So I think if they can come away with a draw here, that would be good for PSG.
And I think that's fair. I think that Mbappe scoring is a pretty good place to put your ideas and probably make your prediction that he does. I mean, odds are, chances are that that's where he is and how they're going to score. The one goal, is that going to be enough? I mean, again, I really do believe that Newcastle has a really good chance to win this. I think that's the mindset and that's what they're going to be going for. Two goals from them, then, if that's the case, to win this 2-1. I don't know. I don't know. Maybe the script is completely flipped, and they're all of a sudden again having the opportunities to create chances to score more goals. I don't know, but it's a tough one. But again, I think I'll go with my initial intuition and where this is that Newcastle will win this 1-0.
I mean, either way, it's going to be a fun game, right? We both have close margins for that. So I'm super excited. Joe's super excited. Hopefully, everyone out there is excited and gets a chance to tune in to this Champions League Match Day 2 matchup. It's going to be great. And till next time, everyone.
Thank you, everyone, for tuning in. If you like what we bring you here at the Pitch Pod, please do us a favor, hit that like and that subscribe. Don't forget, we're available on Apple Podcasts as well as Spotify. Thank you, everyone, and keep pitching out there.
In a game, the round ball, round posts, anything can happen.